Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We're at Wentworth Greenhouses in Rawlinsburg, joined by Margaret Hagen from UNH Cooperative Extension. And Margaret, oftentimes when we try to solve one problem, we end up creating another. And I'm thinking particularly now we're trying to make our houses all weather tight so we don't use a lot of energy. But that creates another problem, doesn't it?
It does create a problem because, especially with new construction, formaldehyde outgasses from the construction materials. And if you have a really tight building, there's really no place for it to go. So NASA did a study in 1989 of houseplants and which ones remove the most outgassing from the air. And this is a little group that they feel does the best job.
Okay. And some of these plants that we have right here?
Right. So this one is golden pothos. Almost everybody can grow something like this. It's very easy to grow. Things in the aglaonema group or the dracaena group are others that are good. Snake plants.
Okay.
Peace lilies.
All right, now you mentioned that. Oh, and of course, our ubiquitous spider plant.
Right.
Which is great because they're impossible to kill.
That's
Believe
right.
me, I have tried. All right. You mentioned that study was done back in 1989, but there was another more recent study.
Right. In 2010, a study was done in South Korea, and what they found actually was, and I don't believe NASA tested these, they found that ferns do a much better job or the best job. And so the little one you have is called Celadrius. It's new on the market maybe 4 or 5 years, and it's commonly found around Christmas time. This one is called Harefoot Fern, which you'll find in lots of independent garden centers at most times of the year. So actually start thinking about if you have tight energy efficient construction, maybe you want to get a couple of ferns for houseplants.
And also you mentioned too that there is, it's not just new construction, but maybe new furniture, new carpeting, things
right,
of that.
Right, things of that nature, because benzene is also one of the gases that's outgassed.
Okay, so I've tried to pay attention, but odds are I'm probably not going to remember all this. Do you have some help for me?
I do actually have some help from you. When you're wandering around in Wentworth greenhouses at the various groups of plants, they often have a little tip sheet with plants listed for you to help you do a better job.
All right. Thanks very much. And that's it for today's Grow It Green. Back to you in the studio.